bless you, family. This is the day that the Lord has made. His word commands us to rejoice and be glad in it. We just want to thank you on behalf of the Bethlehem Baptist Church and myself, Pastor Thomas. We just want to thank you so much for tuning in to our broadcast. Listen, we don't take your presence for granted. We know that you could be viewing any broadcast now, but God has led your steps to our broadcast. And so we believe that there's something that will be said through word, song, or prayer that will be a blessing to your life. Listen, we just want to take a moment for you to like our page, subscribe to all of the information that's below. Take this time now to share the video, subscribe to the links that are below, that way that you can stay connected with us. And so we pray that as you join us for our broadcast right now, that it will be a blessing to you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. We pray that the joy of the Lord will be your strength. Come on and just clap your hands right there where you are. Come on.
You make me happy. You make me whole. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you. You make me happy. You make me whole. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you.
You make me whole.
Lord, you take my.
the name of Jesus Christ. You are the author and the finisher of our faith. Lord God, we come in your presence once more to say thank you. We thank you for today. This is the day which you have made, Lord God, and we do rejoice and we're glad for today. We thank you, Lord God, for your love and for your wisdom. We thank you, oh God, because you're all powerful. Oh God, you're all wise, you're all knowing, oh God. And God, you're all present. So Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God, for all that you're doing in all our lives. We thank you, Father, for this great ministry. We thank you for Bethlehem Baptist Church. We thank you for the body of Christ. We pray, Lord God, for each and every member of this church. We thank you, oh God, that they're walking in divine health. Divine prosperity is theirs. We thank you, Lord God, oh, you bless your people as they go out and as they come in. Blessing them, oh God, on their jobs. Wherever they go, Lord, we thank you, oh God, that the blood of Jesus covers over them, Lord. We pray, Lord God, for those who have lost loved ones. We're praying for them, Lord God. We're praying, oh God, and for Sister Wilhelmina Stewart. We're praying, oh God, for Miss Coletta. We're praying for these here people. All those on the prayer list, Lord God. We add our faith with their faith. Thanking you for your healing in their lives. Oh God, we pray, oh God, even for those who have written in and those who have called in, Lord God. We're adding our faith with their faith. And God, we're thanking you, Lord God. We're thanking you, oh God. We said, be it unto them according, oh God, to your word and according to their faith. So we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord God. We pray, Father, for this Newton County. We pray, oh God, for all elective officials. We pray, oh God, for our elect President Biden and Kamala Harris. We pray for them and their cabinet. We pray, oh God, because your word declare that the king's heart is in the hands of the Lord, and you turn it wheresoever you want to turn it, Lord. So God, you see and you know all things, oh God, that is going on in the land. All things that's going on in this nation, Lord God. Father, I ask you to move by your spirit, Lord God. Have thine own way, Lord God. We thank you, God, for what you have already done and what you're doing right now. We thank you, Lord God, for the sheriff of Newton County. We thank you, oh God, for his department. We thank you, Lord God, for the commissioner, mayor, Lord God. We just pray, oh God, for all your elected officials. We ask you, God, to have your way in their lives. Give them direction, Lord God, as they started out, oh God, to do a new work, Lord God. I pray for them, Lord God. And God, I pray even those who do not know you as Lord and Savior, that salvation will come to their homes. Bless these your people, Lord God. Have your way and have mercy upon each and every one of these your people. And Lord, we thank you. And now, Lord, we pray for the praise team. As they come, Lord, I pray, oh God, that you will anoint their voices afresh. Bless them, oh God, as they sing songs of praise unto you, Lord God. Bless the musicians, Lord God. Bless all those in the media room. Bless these your people, Lord God. Have thine own way in the lives of these your people, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. Lord, we pray for those in the hospitals. Those, oh God, who are sick and afflicted in their bodies. Those, oh God, who have this virus. We're praying for them. We pray for every medical staff. God, we're praying, oh God. Oh God, and ask you, Lord God, to use their hand as a healing instrument for your people. In the name of Jesus Christ. Have your own way, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, for the things which you have done, the things which you're about to do in and through the lives of these your people. And oh Lord, we pray for our pastor. We ask you to cover him and cover his family in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you for his life. God, your word declares. prosper. So, Lord, I thank you for divine health and divine prosperity in his life. I thank you for opening doors for him that no man can shut. And you're shutting doors that no man will ever be able to open. Bless him, oh God, from the top of his head and to the sole of his feet. Cover him with the blood of Jesus. God, I declare and decree that no weapon formed against him will be able to prosper. And any tongue that rises up against him, Lord, judgment, it will show to be in the wrong. I thank you, Lord, that favor is his in the name of Jesus Christ. Favor, Lord God, favor is his in the name of Jesus. Oh God, cover him as we go out and come in. Give him the wisdom of God. Give him the mind of Christ Jesus. Revelation, knowledge, and understanding. I thank you for it. Bless him in a special way, Lord God. Bless these your people, Lord God. I pray, oh God, for the services of today. I pray that your word will go forth, unchecked and unhindered by the powers of darkness. Your word, oh God, will take root and it will heal the peace of the riches of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank you for right now, world. We thank you, Lord God, that many will cry, what must I do to be saved after hearing your word, Lord God? So let your word have its free course. Have your way in the lives of all your people. Have your way in the lives of every member. Have your way, Lord God. We pray a special prayer for all the mothers of Bethlehem Church. Oh God, all deacons, all leaders, Lord. We pray for them, Lord God. A special prayer, Lord God, for the Benton family. We're praying for them, Lord God. We ask you, Lord God, to comfort them and keep them in your care. We love you, Lord, and we thank you for all things. Things you have already done in all our lives. The things which you're doing right now in the spirit realm, and the things that you're about to do in and through our lives. We thank you, oh God, for blessing these, your people, blessing them abundantly, Lord God. They lack nothing. No good thing will you withhold from them that walk uprightly. So God, we thank you. Thank you for being our shepherd. Thank you for being our provider. Thank you for being our way maker. Thank you for being our healer. Thank you, Lord God, for your grace, for your mercy, Lord God. We love you, Lord God, and we thank you. We bless you. We honor you. We exalt you, Lord God. We lift your name up, the name above all names, the name of Jesus, where every knee will bow and every tongue got to confess that Jesus is Lord. Lord, we just thank you for this prayer. And we pray, oh God, that someone, oh God, will be healed, set free, and delivered because of your word. Lord, we love you and we thank you. It is in Jesus' name that we do pray and we give you thanks. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. We serve a mighty God who reigns, he rules and abides. Hallelujah. How many of you are going to let him reign over your life today? Hallelujah. We magnify you, O God. Have your way in our hearts, in our lives. Lord God, be glorified. Hallelujah. Say, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns, Lord, you reign above every name.
Oh, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns,
Lord, you reign
above every name.
My God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God, you reign.
Our God reigns, Lord, you reign above every name. Lord, you reign above every name.
With power and majesty.
With power and majesty. Dominion, authority, you reign.
Hallelujah. How many of you know that with power and majesty, he reigns forever?
With power and majesty.
Dominion and authority, yeah.
You reign.
Hallelujah. Just declare with me, my God reigns. Say, my God
reigns. My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Say, Lord, you reign
above every name.
Come on, declare this. Say, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Say, our God reigns.
Our God reigns. Lord, you reign above every name.
With power and majesty.
With power and majesty.
Dominion and authority. Yeah. Hallelujah. With power and majesty, yeah.
Power and majesty.
Dominion in your hand, oh God.
And authority, you reign.
Oh, say, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Say, Lord, you reign.
Above every name.
Come on, declare that today. Say, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
My God reigns.
Say, Lord, you
reign above every name.
With power and majesty.
Dominion,
hallelujah. Oh, with power and majesty. Say,
power and majesty.
Dominion and authority.
Yeah.
Oh, say, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Say, our God reigns.
Lord, you reign above every name.
My God reigns, my God reigns.
My God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Say, Lord, you reign
above every name.
Declare over my circumstance. Say, over my circumstance. You're giving me another chance.
You reign.
Hallelujah, aren't you so glad that he's giving you another chance? Say, over my circumstance. You're giving me another chance. Oh, I'm so glad about it. Say, over my circumstance. Yeah. Come on, somebody give him glory. Say, over my circumstance. Hallelujah.
Giving me another chance.
Oh, you reign. Hey, you reign.
family, God bless you. Listen, we pray all is well with you. Listen, we just want to take this time to invite you out to our Sunday services at 10:45, as well as our midweek Bible study, our Wednesday walk through the Word at 7 p.m. Look, we look to see you there, but not just you. Tag and invite a friend. God bless you on your journey.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. To the members of Bethlehem and our visitors that are streaming with us, we just want to take a few minutes to welcome you to Bethlehem. Is that all right? Come on, put your hands together. Come on. Come on, if you believe in the Lord for better, put your hands together. Hey. Everybody sing. Everybody sing.
Better.
Believe in the Lord.
Welcome to Bethlehem Baptist Church. Today's announcements are as follows. Have you downloaded the Givelify app? This app allows you to sow no matter where you are and no matter what time of day. As we know, when we sow into fertile ground, we can expect a harvest. This app will make giving easier. Remember, with Givelify, you can give any amount, anytime, and anywhere. So download Givelify, add Bethlehem as your church, and sow today.
Probably been hearing a lot about coronavirus disease 2019, or COVID-19. For most that catch it, the symptoms will be relatively mild. Those who are most vulnerable are the elderly and those with compromised immune systems or other health conditions. To help protect them and avoid spreading the virus, avoid handshakes and wash your hands for 20 seconds with soap and water. When you cough, cover your mouth by coughing into your elbow. Also avoid crowds and unnecessary travel and practice social distancing. If you have flu-like symptoms or have been exposed to COVID-19, stay home, Avoid others and call your doctors before showing up at their office or the emergency room. Visit BaptistOnline.org or call our dedicated hotline at 866-941-4785 for more information. Get better with Baptist.
Concludes today's announcements. For more information, please visit our website at www.BethlehemBaptistCovingtonGA.com. Also, like and follow us on Facebook at Bethlehem Baptist Church Covington GA. That's Bethlehem Baptist Church Covington GA.
Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. His word commands us to rejoice and be glad in it. Is there anybody that's blessed out there on this morning? Come on, if you're blessed, come on, pat yourself on the chest and say, I'm blessed, I'm blessed. Come on, speak it over yourself. The power of life and death is in the tongue. Come on, speak over your life, speak over your family, speak over your future. Say, come on, I am blessed. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. We greet you in the joy of Jesus. And we thank you so much for joining our cyber sanctuary this morning. We believe that your steps have been strategically sent towards our broadcast. And to that end, we believe that there's something that will be said through word, through song, or prayer that will in fact be a blessing to your life. Well, it is so good for you to be worshiping with us. We again thank you so much for stopping in at our broadcast. Again, we don't take your viewing presence for granted, but we pray that all is functioning well with you as well as those that you love. What's more, we want to give a very, 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 very big congratulations to our sheriff who has yet again has secured the sheriff of Newton County, Sheriff Ezell Brown. We want to give him a major shout out again. We're grateful to God because God is faithful. Hallelujah. We also are so grateful for what God is doing, hallelujah, in our nation, that God literally is overturning things and God is showing himself faithful. So we're so grateful, amen, for the change of administration that is going to be present in our country. Hallelujah to that. Amen, somebody. I know that's right. To God be the glory. I pray that you would keep our very own sister Carletta in your prayers as well. We pray for the Benton family. Mother Doris Benton went home to be with the Lord, and that service was on Friday. And so we ask that you would continue to pray for Deacon David Benton as well as their daughters during this period of transition. But we pray that all is functioning well with you as well as those that you love. I want you to know that God is still in control. And in the words of and language of antiquity, as long as he sits high and looks low, eventually everything is going to be all right. Well, God bless you as we prepare to move forward in our services.
Holiness, holiness
From the pastor of Bethlehem Baptist Church, Pastor Ronnie Thomas Jr.
Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Come on, let us pray. Father, we love you. God, we thank you now for all things. God, we thank you, God, for, God, our being here. God, we thank you now, God, for the mere fact that you've canceled our reservation to a cemetery. And the fact, God, that we're inhaling and exhaling, God, says now, God, that the best is still yet to come. Says that the attack of the enemy has been canceled. And so we thank you even now, God, for the best, God. And God, we thank you now for this service. We thank you for the songs that have been sang, God, the prayers that have been offered to you. Now, God, it's preaching time. I realize, God, that I'm not my own, that I was bought with a price on Calvary. So with that being said, God, I pray that you would decrease me to nothing. Please raise your spirit to everything. Allow me to think with your thoughts and speak with your words. I pray, I beg now for pulpiteering power, spiritual stamina, effective communication to the saints. Have your way even now, God. Do it for us now, Father God. Hide me behind illuminating shadows of Calvary's cross, that people will see none of me but all of you. Do it for us now, Father God. Have your divine way, God. God, get the glory while we get the growth, Father God. Preach me to the point of your pleasure, so heaven is happy and that hearts are satisfied. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, God bless you, family. We greet you this morning in the joy of Jesus. There's a word that we want to share. Genesis chapter 22. Genesis chapter 22, commencing at verse 1 and then concluding at verse number 14. Genesis chapter 22, commencing at verse 1 and then concluding at verse 14. I'm reading according to the NIV version of the Bible, but whatever version you have is just that, a version of the Word of God. Genesis chapter 22, commencing at verse 1. Sometime later, God tested Abraham and said, "Abraham, here am I," he replied. Then God says, "Take your son, your only son, whom you love, Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him as a burnt offering on the mountain I will show you." Early the next morning, Abraham got up and loaded his donkey. He took with him his two servants and his son Isaac. And when he had cut enough wood for the burnt offering, he set out for the place that God had told him about. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place from a distance. He said in verse 5 to his servant, "Stay here with the donkey while the boy and I go over there. We're going to worship and we're coming back to you." Verse 6, Abraham took the wood for the burnt offering and placed it on his son Isaac and carried the fire and knife. And as the two of them went together, Isaac spoke and said to his father, "Abraham, father." "Yes, my son," Abraham replied. "The fire and the wood are here," Isaac said. "But where is the lamb for the burnt offering?" Note what Abraham says. Abraham said, "God himself will provide the lamb for the burnt offering, my son." And the two of them went on together. Verse 9, they reached the place that God had told them about. Abraham built an altar there and arranged wood on it. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. And then he reached out his hand and took his knife to slay his son. Verse 11 says, "But the angel of the Lord called out to him from heaven, 'Abraham, Abraham, here am I,' he replied. 'Do not lay a hand on the boy. Do not do anything to him, now that I know that you fear God, because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son.'" Verse 13, "Abraham looked up, and there was a thicket, a ram caught by his horns. He went over, took the ram, sacrificed it as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, 'The Lord will provide.' And to this day, it is said, 'On the mountain of the Lord will be provided.'" And with that thought in mind, my brothers and sisters, I'm certainly needing your prayers, God's power, and the aid of the Holy Spirit. I want to preach this morning what to do when God asks for Isaac. Yeah. What do you do when God asks for Isaac? Do me a favor. If you're sitting beside somebody, look at them in the face and says, neighbor, what do you do when God asks for Isaac? If you're sitting by yourself, encourage yourself, have a productive conversation with yourself and says, what do I do when God asks for Isaac? This morning, my brothers and sisters, it is pivotal that we note as we move forward in this sermonic presentation that God does not tempt us. That according to the Bible in James chapter 1, it says that God cannot be tempted of evil, neither does God tempt with evil. And so from that, we accurately ascertain that God does not tempt us. However, while God does not tempt us, God does test us. And we must further note that while God never tempts us, God will always test us. And that on the contrary, that while Satan does not test us, but Satan, in fact, tempts us. And when you understand that, then you'll understand the canvas that this text is painted on this morning, because Abraham is about to be tested by God. That God literally is testing Abraham's faith. But what's interesting to note is that while this story is familiar to us, what we'll discover is that there has been a foundation previously laid with Abraham and God. When you go back to Genesis chapter 12, Genesis, God tells Abraham, God says, leave the familiar, leave your family, leave your fortune. And the Bible records that Abraham responds in faith. However, when we come to Genesis chapter number 22, we see that God now is requiring more than faith from Abraham. As interesting as that sounds, we must understand that God now is testing Abraham on another level. Can the church say another level? It's important to understand that God tests us on the level that we're able to comprehend. For instance, there are some of you that may be in the field of education, that those of you that are educators, you only give your students a test that you know that they can pass, that you test the student on the level that they're on. And sometimes when we graduate from one level, God will test us in another level. God now is requiring another level. And I need to pull up right there for a point of preachment to let you know that sometimes God will require another level from you. Sometimes God will require another level of faith. Sometimes God will require another level of trust. Sometimes God will require another level of obedience. And this is where we see Abraham. God is now requiring more than faith. God says to Abraham, note if you will, in verse 2, the request made by God. God says to Abraham, he says, give me your Isaac. And that's interesting, church, that we must note, watch this, that God is asking for Isaac. Can the church say Isaac? You Bible readers know that Isaac was the promised son. Isaac was the seed by which generations would flow from Abraham's loins. That God now has asked for Isaac. And so when we look at this, we must understand what Isaac meant to Abraham. And when you understand what Isaac meant to Abraham, then you'll understand what a difficult and daunting task that God had put Abraham up to. Isaac, when you look at it, my brothers and sisters, represented laughter. Isaac represented Abraham's laughter. In fact, Isaac, his name means laughter. That Isaac Isaac brought joy to Abraham's life. Isaac was the promised child. Isaac brought a sense of joy to Abraham's life. Isaac represented laughter. But not only did Isaac represent laughter, Isaac also represented love. And every now and then, God will test you, and he'll put you up to the test to see if what you love, has it taken the place of him. And Isaac represented Abraham's laughter. He represented Abraham's love, but then he represented Abraham's last. And so now we see God, putting Abraham to the test, saying, Abraham, give me your laughter, give me your love, and give me your last. God, by my own estimation, God has asked Abraham a hard thing. But I want to let you know that God will never ask you to do something that you cannot do. And I need to pull up before I go any further. There's somebody, you're looking at your life, you're surveying the situation, you're looking at your life through and through, and you've been presented with some difficult dilemmas. You've been presented with some mountains that seem high that God has asked you to climb. But God is telling me to tell you in a form of encouragement that God won't ask you to do anything that you're not capable of doing. God asked Abraham for his laughter. He asked Abraham for his love, and he asked Abraham for his last. Note in verse number 2, the request made by God. God says to him, he says, give to me that which means the most to you. Watch this. He says, give to me that which means the most to you, your only son. Verse number 2 says, take your only son, Isaac, who you love, watch this, to the region of Mount Moriah, and note, if you will, sacrifice him there, watch this, on the mountain that I will tell you. God has asked him for his laughter. He's asked him for his love, and he's asked him for his last. Note, if you will, the request made by God. But if you look further in verse number 3, after you see in verse 2 the request made by God, in verse number 3, you will see Abraham's response to God. In verse number 3, watch this. It says, early the next morning, Abraham got up and saddled the donkey and took with him 2 servants and his son Isaac. Watch this. And when he had cut the wood for the burnt offering, he set out to the place that God had told him to. Watch this. In verse 2, we see a request made by God. But in verse number 3, we see a response to God. And can I go give you a nugget really quickly, beloved? Watch this. The way that you respond to God, watch this, dictates how God releases to you. Oh, gosh, let me do that again. I just said the way that we respond to God dictates, watch this, how God releases to us. Abraham, watch this, responds in a way, and God ultimately releases to him based off of his response. And God is asking me to pull up right here in the form of question and ask you today, beloved, what is God is saying, what if I responded to you? Help me, God. And release to you based off of the way that you responded to me. God is telling me to ask you, beloved. He says, what if, watch this, I release to you based off of the way that you have responded to me? And God is telling me to tell somebody right there, that is the answer to your question. That is, watch this, here it is, the missing piece to the proverbial puzzle of your life. Because God says, maybe you have not been responding appropriately. Because God says, whenever you respond appropriately, he says, I will release unto you. But here it is, you got to have enough faith in God to respond appropriate. Is there anybody in the house, at your house this morning? and has made up in your mind and says that as of today, I am going to be respond to God, because I understand now based off of how I respond, that dictates how God releases unto me. And here it is, when you respond in obedience, watch this, here it is, God then will release overflow. Come here, you don't believe me? Come here in Malachi. Malachi says, when you bring the whole tithe and offering to the storehouse, then God says, watch this, he says, I'll do something. I'll open up a window and pour out blessing that you don't have room enough to receive. Watch this, because God, watch this, will release based off of how you respond. And I don't know who I'm talking to today, but I need to let somebody know that partial obedience is total disobedience. Maybe that's why you've missed God in this season, because you've not been responding appropriately. But God says, maybe how you respond to me dictate how I release to you. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but God is telling me to tell somebody that this is the season to do your first works all over again. Because God says, here it is, you can have what's in my hand, but God says, you got to first seek my face. God says, when you first, watch this, found the joy of your salvation, you would seek me in the morning, you would seek me in the afternoon, you would seek me in the evening. But God says, now you've grown weary of me. And God says, I'm not releasing unto you. I'm not releasing favor to a person, watch this, that is not responding accurately. And so God says, I am able to release, but are you able to respond? Woo! Do me a favor right there and ask yourself, God says, I'm able to release, but God says, are you able to respond? And however you respond to God dictates how God releases unto you. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but I don't know, I'm at a place in my life where I need God to release everything to me. I need God to help me, God, to pour out blessings that have been locked up. I need God to open up doors that have been closed up. I need to find favor in unusual places. Help me, God. I need to God to open doors and turn things around. But God is saying today, God says, I'm able to release it, but are you able to respond? Watch this. No, if the text, watch this in verse number 2. There's a request made by God. But then in verse 3, Abraham responds to God. But note, if you will, what shouts me. Here it is, beloved, is how he responds to God. Watch, if you will. He responds readily. Can the church say readily? When you look at verse number 3, watch this. There is no space that occurs. His knee-jerk reaction is one of obedience. And verse 2, God says, go ahead and take your son and go ahead and sacrifice him. In verse 3, Abraham does it readily. There is no conversation recorded between Abraham and God. There is no conversation recorded between God and Abraham. And that would have canceled some of us out right there. Some of us, watch this, don't have the ability to respond readily. Because watch this, nowhere do we see Abraham having dialogue with his mouth. We see Abraham responding readily and responding in obedience. And so God, watch this, is looking for somebody to respond readily. God says, whenever I ask for your Isaac, God says, whenever I ask you to move this next time, God says, whenever I ask you to act out of obedience, God says, I need you to respond readily. Can the church say readily? In verse number 3, it says, early in the morning, Abraham got up, saddled his donkey, took with him his two servants. He goes. There's no conversation. There's no vacillating in his faith. There's no reservation. There's no hesitation. There's no backpedaling. He responds readily. And I want to say it again. I've got how you, watch this, respond to God dictates how God releases to you. He responds readily. Can the church say readily? But not only does Abraham respond readily, Abraham responds reverently. He responds reverently in verse number 5. He said to his servants, stay here, watch this, with the donkey, while the boy and I go over there. He says, we're going to worship and we are coming back. Note what he says. He says, we're going to worship and we're coming back. Abraham says, we're getting ready to worship. Nobody has said anything about worship here. Nobody has said anything about worship. In fact, I want to let you know that this is the first time worship is mentioned. Watch this. But watch this. Worship is mentioned. Hear this. Watch this. With in conjunction with sacrifice. And so that tells me to tell you, beloved, that sometimes worship requires sacrifice. Sometimes true praise and true worship to God requires sacrifice. And I can't understand people, watch this, that God, to say they love God. I can't understand that people say they didn't healed by God. I can't understand that people say that the hand of God is on their life. I can't understand people who say they love God. I can't understand people who say God is their everything and they can't worship God. They can't get worship God. Oh, help me God, because of the music is not a certain way. They can't worship God because it's not their type of song. The devil is a liar. If you are a worshiper, you will worship God any kind. Oh God. If you are a worshiper, you will worship God in season. And I, God, deliver me from people who can only worship a certain kind of way. But here it is. When I think about the goodness of the Lord and all that he's done for me, help me, I got to give him praise. That's why I can't hear anybody that sit here and sing about how good he is. That's why I can't just sit down when somebody's lifting up the name of the Lord. That's why I just can't sit down on my blessed assurance when the name of the Lord is going forth, because I know how good he's been to me. God says, however you, watch this, respond to me dictates how I release to you. And God is telling me to tell you, you can get something through your worship. God is telling me to tell you, you can get something in your praise. God is telling me to tell you, you can get something in your thanksgiving. But I don't know about you, but I believe it's about 35 of us that have made up in their mind, help me God, I'm going to get everything that God has for me. Because guess what? I understand, whenever I bless the name of the Lord, that invites his presence into the place. And whenever his presence is there, his power is there also. Here it is. I got to respond because I need a release. Is there anybody that's watching today? If you need something from God, God says right now up in here, if you give me glory right now, if you bless my name right now, if you lift me up right now, come on, if you give me a sacrifice of praise right now, everything that you need is coming to pass. Every door that you need open is going to be open. Every enemy is going to be made your footstool. Every crooked place is going to be made straight. Every mountain is going to be leveled. Every valley is going to be exalted. Every river is going to be dried up. God is getting ready to do it. Just tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, hallelujah. God is getting ready to do it. That was the wrong neighbor. Find another one and says, neighbor, God is getting ready to do it. So watch this. Note, if you will, Abraham responds readily. Watch this. He responds reverently. But then, watch this. He responds reassuredly. Oh, Jesus. Note what the text says in verse number 5. He says, we are going to worship, then we're coming back to you. He says, we're going to worship, and then we're going back to you. You missed your chance to shout right there, because in verse number 2, God has made a request. God says, Abraham, you're going to go to the altar, and you're going to sacrifice your son. Note, if you will, there is no further conversation as it relates to God's plan with Abraham. But Abraham responds reassuredly. Abraham says, the Lord and I are going to worship, and we're coming back. Oh gosh. So I had a conversation with Abraham before I got here, and I says, Abraham, how was it, sir, that you was able to tell the servants that we're going to worship and we're coming back? Well, Abraham says, I've had history with God. I had equity with God. And what I know, watch this, that you can't make me doubt him, because I know too much about him. And whenever you had a history with God, whenever you had a track record with God, whenever you had a past with God, the ways that he's made in the past gives you, watch this, reassurance in the present. And God is telling me to tell somebody, you got to look back over your life. You got to take a trip back down memory lane, and you got to remember the ways that he's already made. And when you remember what he has done, that gives you reassurance in the present. Come here, Abraham. Abraham, he looked back over his life. Abraham looked back how he left in Genesis chapter number 12 when he took God at his word. When he says, go to a place where I will show you. He says, leave your family, leave your friends, leave your fortune. He says, leave everything behind. And watch this, Abraham, after leaving everything behind, has understood how God has been with him, has understood where the Lord has brought him from. And so now he can get in the day of conflict and have a sense of confidence in conflict because he understands what God has done. And God is telling me to tell somebody, God says, even though I'm asking you for Isaac in this season, I may be asking you for the thing that is your laughter. I may be asking you for the thing that is your love. I may be asking you for your last. But God says, you got to respond to me the right way. Because he says, how you respond to me dictates how I release to you. And I praise God today for Abraham, because he shows us that we've got to respond readily. We got to respond reverently, but then we got to respond reassuredly. Tell your neighbor, says neighbor, how you respond to God, it dictates how God releases to you. And here it is, and then we're going to get out of here, Mark, and we're going to run on and see what the end is going to be. Watch this, here it is. In verse number 2, there's a request made by God. In verse number 3, there is a response to God. I told you, watch this, how you respond to God dictates how God releases to you. Abraham, watch how he responds. He responds readily in verse number 3. He responds reverently in verse number 5. He responds reassuredly in verse number 5. And because Abraham in verse 3 responded readily, because he responded reverently, because he responded reassuredly, God released to him. But note, if you will, church, how God released to him. God provided a ram. But what shocks me is how God provided this ram. Here it is. God provided the ram suddenly. Can the church say suddenly? In Genesis chapter number 22, verse number 13, watch what the text says. The text says, watch this, Abraham looked up there, watch this, and in the thicket he saw a ram caught by its horns. He went over and took the ram, watch this, and sacrificed it as a burnt offering instead of his son. Are you with me on today? Here it is. God has provided a ram. When you look at the grammatical structure, this suggests that the ram was not there, but suddenly the ram appeared. And God is telling me to tell you, that's how things are going to happen for you. It's going to happen suddenly. Jesus, would you do me a favor and shout into the atmosphere and say, things are going to happen for me suddenly. That means that one minute is not going to be there, but the next minute is going to be there. That means one minute the door is going to be closed, but the next minute the door is going to be open. It's going to happen suddenly. That somebody, you need to know that your breakthrough is coming suddenly. So that means at any moment, oh, Jesus, your breakthrough could be coming. And so that's why you got to give God praise. That's why you got to be like David and say, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth, because I'm expecting something to happen, but I'm expecting it to happen suddenly. Would you do me a favor? Oh gosh, and encourage yourself and say, I'm expecting it to happen in my life suddenly. I'm expecting my sadness to stop suddenly. I'm expecting to be healed suddenly. I'm expecting something new suddenly. I'm expecting something different suddenly. How can you expect the sudden? I can expect the sudden because I responded in obedience. And that right there is enough to give God praise for. Because if you responded in obedience, you should give God praise. You should be tearing up your living room right there, because you know that something is coming your way, and it's gonna come suddenly. So here it is.
God releases to Abraham suddenly. Do me a favor and says, God is getting ready to release to me suddenly. But not only did God release suddenly, check it, verse number 13, still, God released strategically. Can the church say strategically? Verse 13 says, Abraham looked up there, and in a thicket he saw the ram. Watch this. And the ram is caught by its horn. That he strategically has something caught up for me, and it is caught up in the thicket, and it cannot go anywhere, help me God, until I come put my hands on it. Jesus, somebody, you need to know you're not gonna miss your blessing. Somebody, you need to know you're not gonna miss the season, because it's caught up in the thicket. Jesus, that your blessing is caught up and it can't go anywhere. It's caught up, it is waiting for you. And here it is. God is telling me to tell you, while you're waiting for it is being made ready for you. Did you hear what I just said? God says, while you're waiting for it is being made ready for you. You don't have to worry about missing the opportunity. You don't have to worry about missing the moment. God says, in this season, you can't, Jesus. God says, in this season, you can't miss your blessing. Who am I talking to? God says, in your past, you mismanaged some stuff. God says, in your past, you missed some blessings. But God says, because it's caught up for you, God says, because it's hung up for you, it's waiting there for the right time. God has strategically placed it there. Watch this. Here it is. God has released to Abraham. And I want to suggest the same way that God is releasing to Abraham, it's the same way that God is going to release to you. It's the same way that God is going to release to our church. God is going to do it suddenly. But not only is God going to do it suddenly, God is going to do it strategically. But then, watch this, here it is, what it shocks me, and then I'm out of here. God does it suddenly. God does it strategically. But then God, watch this, provides a substitution. Here it is. Note, if you will, and then we're out of here. Here it is. If the ram, watch this, is not there, check it, Isaac still dies. But when Abraham sees the ram, he goes and unties it. And he lays a ram on the altar. And he lays a ram on the altar as a substitution for a sacrifice. And that right there is enough to give God praise for right there. Because here it is, what the ram did for Abraham and Isaac, a lamb did for us. You missed what I just said. I'm out of here, Mark. I'm ready. I said, what the ram did for Abraham and Isaac, a lamb did for us. One more time. One for the Father, one for the Son, and this one for the show enough Holy Ghost. Here it is. I said, what the ram did for Abraham and what the ram did for Isaac is what the lamb does for us. What lamb? The lamb that was slain before the foundations of the world. The lamb, help me God, that stood in the gap for man. The lamb that came down through 40 and two generations. The lamb that provided a substitute for us. And that lamb is Jesus, the risen Christ. Can I tell the story and pack it up and get out of here? The Bible says that he came to his own, and that his own received him not. They led him up from hall to hall. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head in the locks of his shoulders. And the Bible says that he died until the sun refused to shine. He died until the earth began to reel and rock. He died and kept on dying until dead men got out of their grave and Jerusalem and walk. But he kept on dying until the centurion had to eulogize him and said, surely this was the Son of God. And so then the Bible records that he died dying all night Friday. He dying all night Sunday. But early, I said early, Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. And because he lives, you got a substitution. Because he lives, how you respond dictates how God releases. It happened the same way with Jesus. Here it is. When he responded in obedience, God says, I'll so highly exalt you and give you a name above every name, that at that name every knee will have to bow and every tongue will have to confess that Jesus is Lord. And so bye-bye, y'all. See you next week on church anniversary. But all I wanted to tell you, there may be a time when God asks for Isaac, when God asks for your love, when God asks for your laughter, and when God asks for your last. But if ever God asks for your Isaac, be not dismayed. Whatever be tied beneath his wings of lullaby, I said, God, he will take care of you. So if he asks for your Isaac, respond in obedience. Because I believe that God won't let you. He won't let you outgive him. The more you give, the more he'll give it back. I am a living testimony that if you give God, if you give him your Isaac, he will make it all right. I'm a living witness today that if you trust God and take him at his word, his word shall not return void. I'm a living witness that if you take God at his word, he'll wipe your stained eyes. I'm a living witness that if you take the Lord at his word, when you walk the floor at night, he'll hold your hand. I'm a living witness when you're crying tears of pain, he will comfort you. Lo, he'll be with you even until the end of the age. And so my job this morning is to encourage your heart that if God asks for your Isaac, if you have to say farewell, if you have to say bye-bye, have a spirit like Job. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord give it. And the Lord take away. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God, for the time that you had with Isaac. Thank God for the memories that you had with Isaac. Thank God for what you experienced with Isaac. But God is not the kind of God that will take from you without making preparations to give back to you. So do me a favor, pat yourself on the chest and say, it's coming back. Woo! Say, it's coming back. Yes, sir. It's coming back. But when it comes back, it's coming back better. It's coming back stronger. It's coming back with everything that I wanted. And somebody today, God is telling me to tell you, respond the right way. Respond readily. Respond reverently. Respond reassuringly. You got to have so much confidence that things are going to work out on your behalf. You got to have so much confidence that if they lay you off the job, you'll get a better job. You got to have so much confidence that if your boo leaves you, God will do me a favor. I felt that in my shadow. Seek an emotion. God will. Oh, yes, he will. God will. God will. God will. Oh, I said, God will. He will. He will. He'll provide another ram. Tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, you might have lost some stuff in 2020. 2020 has been hell for us all. But guess what? recovery, that you're coming back better, you're coming back stronger, you're coming back wiser, you're coming back with more anointing. And if you believe that you're coming back, do it until he does it. Do it, but shout now. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. What do you do when God asks for your Isaac? You need to understand how you respond dictates how God releases. Somebody, you want it to happen suddenly for you? Respond the right way. Because how you respond dictates how God releases. I want to pray over your life. Father, we love you. Oh God, we thank you for all things. God, if you ask us the hard thing, if you ask us for Isaac, give us now the ability to respond appropriately, God. Give us the ability to respond in a way that honors you, that lifts you up, trusting, God, that you won't take from us without making preparations to give back to us. So we love you. We thank you that you give us more peace for the peace we lost. Give us more joy for the joy we lost. Give us more happiness for the happiness we lost. We love you, God. We thank you. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Listen, the doors of the church are open. You may be out of the ark of safety. You may not know Jesus in the pardon of your sin. But hallelujah. Watch this. This God releasing to you does not happen until you first have positioned yourself to be in right standing with him. That your salvation first has to be sealed before God releases, before he restores. The first thing, the main thing, is your salvation. It is, in fact, your eternal resting place. So if you're out of the ark of safety, come on, if you're not sure about your salvation, you can inbox us below, you can comment, you can email the church, you can call the church. We have persons that will walk you through the plan of salvation. Listen, if you want to be a member of our church, listen, we would love to have you as a member. I want to be your pastor. Our deacons want to be your deacons. Our mothers want to be your mothers. We want to push you to that place so you can be everything that God says you can be, have everything that God says you can have, and do everything that God says that you can do. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Listen, you can inbox us, you can comment below, you can call the church. We have persons that are available to you to help assimilate you to our ministry. Well, we believe that there's no worship presentation that is complete without the presentation of a gift. And so to that end, we now set this time aside in our service for you to give back a portion of that which God has given unto you. If you were blessed by the word, sow into this word that you've been blessed, seal this word with a seed. I believe that there's power in seed. If this was your word specifically, come on, sow into this word, sow into this fertile ground. Hallelujah. That is the Bethlehem Baptist Church. Listen, I believe in giving. I believe in the power of giving. I believe God's word is true. I know his word is true, that the more you give, the more that you will have it to give. God will give seed to the sower. There are promises as it relates to your giving that says he will open up windows, pour out blessing, that you don't have room enough to receive. But it starts with faith. How you watch this respond dictates how he release. Somebody, you want a blessing in your finances. Well, the blessing that you're looking for, the breakthrough that you're looking for in your finances, is going to come from your obedience to God as it relates to your finances. So while you're getting that seed together, I want to pray over that seed now. I want to attach an expectation to that seed now in the name of Jesus. I want to attach an expectation to it. Father, we thank you now for these seeds. We thank you for those that are giving, God. We thank you now, God, for those, Father God, that are sowing into the kingdom.
So now, God, I pray that tangible blessing will be the portion. Tangible blessing and tangible favor, as well as intangible favor, would in fact be their portion, God. I pray now that this seed will give them dreams. This seed will give them vision. This seed will give them what they need, God, in the name of Jesus. So please now do it for them, God. Release unto them, God, in the matchless name of Jesus, the risen Christ, we pray. Amen. Well, God bless you, family. We love you. Thank you so much. For worshiping with us. Listen, next Sunday is our church anniversary. I ask that you would join us for our church anniversary. 171 years. God has been so faithful. This church also, it'll make 1 year in our newly renovated sanctuary. So we're so grateful to God. So I ask that you will tune in on next week, as well as you will tune in for Bible study as well, as we go into our teaching again, the mission of the church in the 21st century. This week coming up, we're going to be talking about unity, placing emphasis on unity. So ask that you will join us next week and join us again. So listen, we love you. We pray that all is well with you. We pray that God's peace and God's favor is your portion. Come on, let us receive our final prayer and benediction simultaneously. Father, we love you. We thank you. What our eyes have seen, our ears have heard. We thank you now, God, for the favor that you've released in this hour, in this time. We pray now for a fresh wind. We pray now, Father God, that you would encourage us, that you would give us what we need. Feel like, God, that we can move forward, God, that we can go forward, God, in favor and in faith. So now, God, every good thing that comes to our mind, let it come to pass. Everything our hand touch, let it be blessed, Father God. We pray now, Father God, that there's favor in our footsteps, in our future, and even over our foes. So we love you, God. We thank you that our footsteps are guarded, guided, and they guarantee blessing. Dismiss us from this broadcast, but never your presence. Cover us in your blood. Bless our families and those that are connected to us. We love you. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you, family. We love you. We'll see you next week. Stay encouraged. God bless you. We love you.